Pain, pain, go away. Don't ever come again another day. Now that's the grown-up version of the nursery rhyme we knew as kids. And having gone through life a fair bit, I'll take rain anytime over pain. But that's what unites us as human beings. The existence of pain and suffering, trials and challenges, that's the common thread that weaves through the whole fabric of humanity. To be alive is to feel pain. And pain comes in all forms and from everywhere. Consider this situation, someone who's lost all their income, living off limited savings, having three kids to feed. Or what about someone who's been sick for many years, going from doctor to doctor, yet not getting any better? And all that she can do is medicate that pain away. Or maybe you've been cheated on, a betrayal of trust that caused the pain so deep, the kind of pain that you can't medicate away. Or what about losing a loved one who died young? Like the time when a 15-year-old boy drowned because he was trying to save someone else from drowning. I know what that kind of loss and pain feels like because that 15-year-old boy, he was my youngest brother. And I know that everything I've mentioned so far doesn't even scratch the surface of what it means to suffer or face challenges as a human being. Now consider this. Consider it a gift. Consider it joy when you face challenges from all sides, because when under pressure, your faith is forced out into the open and shows its true colors. Now I know it doesn't make immediate sense and it goes against everything we feel, but the question is this: will you live by faith or by feelings? Is God still God, or do we now idolize the idea of a pain-free, comfortable life? To consider it joy when we face trials is to change our lenses and see through the filter of faith. You see, joy is not happy feelings that come and go depending on what happens to us. Joy is not situation dependent. Pure joy is the awareness of God's favor and grace upon our lives. And this joy gives strength. Think of a time when you endured something really challenging. It was probably easier to complete that if it was something that you found joy in. But there's no better example than a mother who endures the pain of childbirth because she anticipates the joy of holding the newborn baby in her arms. And it was joy that gave even Jesus strength to endure the cross. The joy of knowing what his death would accomplish for you and me. Yes, I know there's a certain kind of joy in overcoming challenges, but the kind of joy that we need is the one that gives us strength no matter what the outcome may be. You see, because joy in every situation gives us strength for every situation. Consider then the hard times a gift, because it doesn't just bring out your faith in the open, it also brings out the real you. Who are you after walking through fire? Because in the end, what really matters is not what happened to you, but who did you become? I'm not saying it's easy, it's actually really hard. And I don't have all the answers. I can't even imagine the pain some of you might be going through. That's why we really need the awareness of God's favor and grace upon our lives. And with so many things beyond our control, what we can control is this: the filter through which we see everything. Is it the filter of faith? Now, consider that.